In this video, you will learn how to evaluate your AI agents, LLM calls, and RAG systems in N8N. By the end, you will have the critical skill to measure the success and the performance of your AI workflows with actual numbers and not just guesswork. We will build evaluation mechanisms to evaluate this customer support agent, which has access to multiple tools and vector embeddings in Supabase. And we will evaluate the correctness of the response generated by this AI agent, and whether it used the correct set of tools to fulfill that request, and whether it picked up the correct docs from the vector embeddings in Supabase. We will also see how to set up this dataset that can be used to evaluate different scenarios and corner cases. Let's get started. Let's start with the basics and understand what evaluation really means. So we have a very simple AI agent over here, which is a customer support agent, and it has access to the send email, create ticket, and Supabase vector store tools. Supabase vector store will give it access to all the company documents that were converted into embeddings and stored in the Supabase. The manual way of checking the performance of this agent is to open this chat over here and then enter different types of queries one by one covering different scenarios, then execute the workflow, then check if it invoked the correct tools and in the correct sequence, and did it really pull the correct documents from the vector database, and then evaluate the quality of the responses it has generated. But as you can see, you can't repeat this process for a large number of queries. It means that your testing will be limited to only a few queries. And once you make improvements to the prompt or the tools or anything else, you would want to run the test for all of those queries again and then reevaluate everything. So it's really time consuming and impractical. And that's where N8N's evaluation node come into the picture. If we search for evaluation, we will see one node which has four actions and one trigger. If we select the trigger, we will see this node over here. And inside this node, you will see that you have an option to select your Google Sheet and the dataset from there. What this effectively means is that you need to create a Google Sheet that looks something like this. And this is where you define all of your input questions, your expected answers, your expected tools, categories, or anything else that you want to measure. So in this example, I have created a number of questions. These are the input questions, then these are the expected responses. And for this input question, I expect this tool to be invoked. So this evaluation trigger node will pull all of these rows from this Google Sheet, and it will trigger this AI agent one by one, and it will measure the quality of the response, the number of tokens consumed in each request, all the tools that were used in that request, and so on. This is the trigger that begins the evaluation. Apart from that, we have these four actions that we can perform. If we select the operation as set inputs, then this is where we can define additional columns that will show up in the final evaluation. Then we have set outputs. So this is where we can define all the outputs or the column values that we want to update back in our Google Sheet. So let's say if we want to update the tool correctness score, so we can give that name over here, and this is where we can put the evaluated value, and this will be updated in our Google Sheet. The next operation is set metric. In the set metrics operation, we can define all the metrics that we want to measure and analyze in our evaluations tab. So this is the evaluations tab, and this is where you can run your test. So when you run the test, at the top, you will see the list of metrics that you have created in your workflow. You can select any of these metrics, and you will see the results of all of your previous runs. So there are a number of predefined metrics that we can choose from. First one is correctness, AI-based. So this will simply make a call to your preferred LLM model. So we need to attach a model over here to this node. Let's say OpenAI's GPT 4.1 mini, and then this node will make a request to OpenAI, and this is the predefined prompt with this node. Here we need to give the expected answer, and here the actual answer which is generated by the AI agent. We can get the expected answer from our Google Sheet, which is defined over here, and then this LLM model will return a score from 1 to 5 telling us the quality of the response. We have other options like helpfulness. So this is to check whether the response addresses the query. It also uses a scale of 1 to 5. Then we have string similarity. It tries to check if the two strings are similar or not. Then we have categorization. It checks whether the answer exactly matches the reference answer. Then we have tools used. If we select this, we need to give the expected list of tools that were supposed to be executed with the given user query. And this is where we need to give the intermediate steps written from the AI agent node. This node will then find the tools executed and listed in the intermediate steps and whether they were supposed to be executed as per the list of expected tools. And the last metric is the custom metric. So this is where you can define your own metric. You can give it a name, and this will always be of type number because we are giving it a score. And this is where you need to give the value of that metric. And the last thing I want to talk about is this operation called check if evaluating. If we select this operation, this node will act as a if node where it will check if the current workflow run is for evaluation or not. This is required because let's say if you want to add evaluation to this workflow. We will first add a trigger that will pull all the rows from our Google Sheet. We will attach it to the support agent. And before we return response to the user, we can add this if node, which will check if the current workflow run is for evaluation or not. If it is a normal run and not for evaluation, then in that case, we can return the response or take any other actions that we want to take in production. Otherwise, we can add a different flow for this evaluation. For example, we can set metrics. Now, the reason we need this evaluation is because LLM calls, AI agents, or RAG systems produce non-deterministic outputs. For the same input, they can give different outputs. AI agents have multi-step reasoning. They plan, act, observe, and then adjust. And these agents have access to a number of tools, and the tool uses decisions can vary. And therefore, it is necessary to determine the performance of your AI agents or RAG system or your LLM calls. And this is how our dataset looks like. All of these columns are pre-created while creating the dataset, and all the other columns are to be updated by our workflow when the evaluation is run for each of these rows. We have input question, the expected answer for that question. Expected tools contains the names of the tools that we expect our AI agent to execute while processing each of these requests. Then there is a category defined for the type of input question. And then we have these columns which are supposed to be updated by our workflow, like actual answer, actual tools, the response quality score, tool correctness score, tokens used in the workflow, and the reasoning summary. Reasoning summary will explain the reason for the respective response quality scores. And this is the sample company knowledge base doc that I have used to create the embeddings in Supabase. Now to generate this dataset, you can use ChatGPT or Claude. You can go and give a prompt like this. It's a really long prompt, so I'll not read the entire thing. We are giving the company knowledge base doc to it. Then we are defining all the tools which we have attached to our AI agent, how they work, their purpose, when to use them, and some examples. Then we have some tool usage optimization rules, then evaluation dataset requirements that we want to produce. And then we have given a distribution of different queries that we want Claude to generate. So the distribution looks like this. Knowledge base queries, 15 cases. So it will generate 15 questions, their expected answers, and the expected tools that should be executed. The second category is account specific issues. So it will generate 6 cases for that. The third category is complex multi-step cases. So it will have 3 queries in this category. And these cases will require multiple tools to be executed. And it will generate 1 edge case, like for boundary testing or inappropriate requests. In this example, I'm just generating around 25 queries. Then this is the expected output format. Then there is a list of specific test scenarios to include. And finally, some output instructions. If you want, you can also create a separate workflow that would generate multiple questions and answers and save them to your Google Sheet. Along with this prompt, I have attached that company doc, and this is what I got. All the input questions, the expected answers, all the expected tools, their categories. And this is how the updated workflow with evaluation nodes looks like. To begin with, we have the evaluation triggers. This first node will fetch all the rows from our Google Sheet one by one. And then in this set node, we are matching it with the chat input format. We are creating a variable called chat input and providing the input question over here. Let's execute this once. And now if we execute this set node, we will get chat input as the question. And then we are forwarding it to the AI agent. AI agent will process it. And in the response, we will find the output, which is the response to the query, and then an array of intermediate steps. This array contains all the tools that were invoked by the AI agent, the number of tokens they consumed, the messages exchanged with LLM, etc. And we got this intermediate steps array because we have enabled this return intermediate steps flag over here. Next, we are using the check if evaluating node, which will check if the current execution is for evaluation or is it for production. Since it is for evaluation, this branch got set. And then we are making a simple call to OpenAI, and we are evaluating the quality of the response generated by the agent. So this is the prompt we have used, and we are providing the expected response type and the actual response type. And then it will try to evaluate the response and will come up with a score from 1 to 5. Once this is done, we have two branches. In one branch, we are setting metrics for response correctness, and we are providing the score over here. This will represent how correct the response was. This metric will be accessible in the evaluations tab in our graph. We will look at that shortly. And in the other branch, we are using a set node to set all of these different parameters like actual question, actual tools, tokens used, response quality score, and reasoning summary. Reasoning summary is coming from the previous LLM call that we made, and it explains why it gave a score of 3. Once this is done, we are using set outputs operation in this evaluation node, and this will update all of these columns in our Google Sheet. The actual answer, actual tools, tokens used, tool correctness score, response quality score, and reasoning summary. And once this is done, we are creating another metric for tools used. We are giving the expected tools that were supposed to be executed by agent, and we are giving the list of intermediate steps. And this node will automatically find all the tools that were executed, and it will compare it with the expected list. And then it will give out a score of 0 or 1. 0 means the correct set of tools were not invoked. 1 means the correct set of tools were invoked. Now to run the evaluations, we need to go to Evaluations tab at the top. And here we can click on Run Test. I have already run it a couple of times, and that's what you're seeing. And one thing to note here is that I have used this OpenAI node to evaluate the quality of the response instead of using this correctness AI based metric, which is already present in this evaluation node. At times, because of some bug, this particular metric doesn't work correctly and the evaluation fails with the error set metrics node is not configured. Now let's run the evaluation. It was successfully triggered and now it's in progress. In the meantime, I want to show that in this customer support agent, currently we are using a very simple system message. You are a helpful assistant, use appropriate tools to help the customer. As you can see, it won't be very effective and there is a lot of scope for improvement. First, let's wait for this evaluation to complete. We will look at the scores and then make a couple of improvements. And then we will rerun the evaluation. And finally, the evaluation is complete. These are all the test cases that it has executed, which corresponds to all the rows we have in our Google Sheet. And if we go back to all runs, we can see a graph over here and we can select all the metrics that we want to analyze. Let's say we want to check if all the correct tools were used or not by the agent. This is the graph for tools used. Similarly, we can select all other metrics, for example, response correctness, and this is the graph. Likewise, if you make a couple of changes in your workflow and if you run these evaluations again and again, you can get an idea of where are you heading. Are your changes improving the workflow or is it degrading it? Likewise, we can select total tokens to see how many tokens were consumed on an average across all the executions. It consumed 1659 tokens on an average for each question. And if we look at our Google Sheet, all of these columns have been populated successfully. The actual answer, actual tools, tool correctness score, response quality score, and reasoning summary. Tokens used column has not been updated correctly. It seems there is some bug while calculating the number of tokens over here. But I think we don't need to calculate it separately since the number of tokens are anyways available in the evaluations over here. But apart from that, we have everything. We have the response quality scores and we have reasoning for all of those scores. Important thing to note here is that in the tool correctness, we are getting 0.68, which means 68% of the time tools were chosen correctly. And if we select response correctness, we are getting 3.84, which means that 3.84 is the average score out of 5 for all the queries. Now let's make a couple of improvements to the agent prompt and the model settings. So this current prompt has multiple issues. The tool usage instructions are very vague. There are no guidelines on the output message. And now let's start improving it. First, let's add the tool selection decision tree. So this is how it should decide which tool to use for what kind of requests. Next, let's add the response structure on what all to include in the response. And let's add some quality standards. And apart from that, we can make a couple of changes to our chat model. Let's change the temperature to 0.2 so that it doesn't make up things on its own. And with these modifications, let's save the workflow, go to the evaluations and run the test again. It took a couple of minutes, but finally the evaluation is complete. And now if we select tools used, we can see a jump from 0.78, which is 78%, to 88%, which means that for 88% of the test scenarios, correct tools were used by the agent. So we were able to improve our tool selection. Let's look at the response correctness as well. And response correctness has improved from a score of 3.84 to 3.96. It's not a big change, but there is some improvement. If we look at the total tokens, it has increased from 1659 to 2800. It's because now we have a longer system prompt, which is getting sent in each request. Now we can repeat this exercise. We can improve the prompt further. We can add some examples and then we should see more improvements over here. And going forward, let's say if you get a requirement to add more tools over here or update the prompt so that this agent can address more number of scenarios, then all you need to do is add those new test cases in this sheet and then come back here and run the evaluation. And you will be able to see if your changes have degraded the performance or it has improved it. I hope you got a complete understanding of why evaluations are important, how to set them up, and how to use them to improve the performance of your LLM calls, AI agents, or RAG. And if you're someone just getting started with AI or actively building AI solutions, but want to take it to a next level, then don't forget to check out my AI Architects Pro community. You will find multiple detailed courses in this community. Flow Builder will teach you everything about N8N from scratch. Agent Forge will teach you everything about AI agents and how to architect and build multi-agent workflows that are effective and reliable. And in the Systemsmith, I will cover end-to-end AI systems for businesses. Apart from that, you will get full technical support from me. You will find people who are serious, actively learning and building solutions in this space. I want to call out the plan-based restrictions on evaluations in N8N. If I copy this entire workflow, create a new workflow and paste it over there, and then switch to the evaluations tab, there is no button to run the evaluations the way we had for this previous workflow over here. And you will see this message, limit reached. And the reason is the community plan allows only one workflow with evaluations for free. If you are using their cloud service and if you are on Pro or Enterprise plan, then you can have unlimited evaluation workflows. But for the community version, you can have only one workflow with evaluation nodes attached. If you want to run the evaluation on another workflow, then you will have to delete the evaluation nodes from the first workflow. You can download this entire workflow from my free school community. You can find the link in the description. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.